gentlemen, Mr. Gary Bird from Manchester 31, Professional Boxing Promotions, proudly presents our final bout of the evening. Four rounds of boxing in the super middleweight division. Our timekeeper at the bell for this contest is Andrew East. Our referee, trial referee in the ring, David Mulholland. And our senior referee scoring the bout from ringside is Darren Sargeson. Ladies and gentlemen, that is our officials. It is now time to introduce our boxers who are on the right and ready to fight. Introducing first and boxing out of the red corner, wearing the white shorts. He weighed in 11 stone, 10 pounds and 5 ounces. This evening taking part in his 21st contest as a professional, introducing the Stainforth Chuck Norris, Jake Bray! And ladies and gentlemen, please welcome his opponent facing him across the ring and boxing out of the blue corner. He's wearing the black shorts and weighed in 11 stone, 11 pounds and 5 ounces. Making his debut as a professional, Daniel Nathan!
Okay, ladies and gents, this is our final bout of the evening. Nathan Shepherd, based in York, against Jake Bray, the Stainforth Chuck Norris. What a great name that is. So Nathan's clearly bought a few. It's his pro debut. And he has a legend in his corner, actually, in Henry Wharton.
Henry Wharton, what a fighter.
What a fighter he was. And he gets off to a good start there.
Yeah, some, I mean, your pro debut, obviously, you got the nerves, but he's brought a very, very good support of him here, and they're very vocal. And with this venue, the fans are pretty much on top of the ring. Honestly, it's very, very loud in here.
He really snuck in a good right onto the body there. And again, and that is a hurtful shot.
I think he hurt him.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think he hurt him there.
And Jake is quite an experienced guy himself, 20 fights to his name. He's got an experienced cornerman, James Harrington there, Jimmy Harrington in there, my old mate. And let's see how he gets on, because Nathan Shepherd, or Shep Dog as he's called, looks like he's full of ambition here.
Yeah, he's brought a good support. He wants, obviously, put a show on, and He's just settling into this nice, and he's landing some really good body shots.
Yeah, he did take a left hook back there. Didn't seem to faze him, but again, like we learned in the last fight, Dan, you cannot blink for a second here. You've got to really stay focused.
No, he's got to, but I like what I see. He's just taking that nice sort of step back. I like fighters when they come out with the intent, Aki, when they come out, they're on the debut and they're looking to put the opponent on the back foot.
Yeah.
Looking to make a really positive start.
Yeah, and I think that's it. And I think, his large crowd behind him is going to drive him forward. Just needs to make sure he just does his own work, though. He doesn't get too influenced by the crowd. It's hard. It's easier said than done.
Yeah, there's a lot to deal with because it's his pro debut and the crowd as well. So there's a bit of pressure on him, but he looks quite calm at the moment. He's got to be careful coming in because Jake is looking to counter. And like you say, he landed with the left hook not too long ago. Nathan just stalking Jake a little bit now. He's got to keep Jake on the back foot for me. Nice little body shot.
I think he's targeting the body well, isn't he? And that's something on a pro debut. It's quite good to see that, isn't he?
Yeah. Jake's... He's had 25 fights. He's on the road. I think Nathan has started right. You've got to get on the front foot. You've got to back him up, and you've got to let these guys know that they're in a fight. You've got to try and knock the ambition out of him in the first round, because if fighters like Jake, like we've seen early on in the card, if they start growing in confidence, it becomes a different fight. Some throwback songs for you here, Aki.
You know what? You say for me, but you cannot be that much younger than me. How old are you?
30s.
You sound like David Brent. 33.
both 30s.
I'm only just about 30s, mate. And you're hanging on for dear life, so... But yeah, some proper tunes here, and we're getting in the mood for this. A bit of Sunday boxing, Sunday afternoon boxing, stroke evening. Really enjoyed it. Five fights. They were scheduled to be seven. It ended up with five fights on the night, but you know what? This has not put the crowd off from turning up.
I think there's appetite for Sunday boxing, Sunday afternoon. I mean, you look at this venue now, it's packed out.
Yeah.
I'm not sure it'd be this packed out on a Saturday night.
Yeah. Yeah, you're probably right there.
I think Gary's putting a great show here, I really do.
Yeah.
I think there's been some good fights. They've not all gone the way they should have or would be expected. It's been a good night.
And we are into the final bout of the, I'll say evening now. We've got Nathan Shepherd in there from York. He's making his pro debut against Jake Bray. Who, if he's here with Jimmy, he must have come from Doncaster. The more experienced of the two, obviously. Nathan got off to a good start.
I think with Nathan, we're talking about the crowd being here and how he's got to fight his own fight and that. But there is an element of this sport. If you sell tickets, you've got to provide entertainment.
Yeah.
And there is an element where he has got to put a bit of a show on, because you know yourself, we've been about this game a long time, and you sell tickets, you're an exciting fighter, doors open for you.
Absolutely. You sell tickets and, you know, it's only a matter of time before one of the big promoters snaps you up, because, obviously, they say boxing's a business, so, you know.
Yeah. And Nathan, obviously a popular guy to have people... coming over from Doncaster, is it, to Manchester?
Oh, Nathan, based in York.
York.
And he has them, they're a rowdy crowd as well. Gary's had him on the ale from three at the bar. But yeah, he's putting his shots together nicely. He always finishes downstairs.
And I don't want to jinx a fighter like you did, but he looks cautious enough, which I like. So he's putting his shots together. He's got the intent, but he's also thinking about what might be coming back. Taking that little step back, he's moving his head a little bit.
Yeah, because Jake is no mug. Jake Bray is no mug. You know, he's been in there with some good kids himself.
Nice body shot again.
Yeah.
Works the body well. I mean, may not be a telling factor in this fight, but when he starts slipping up the rounds and they go a bit longer, 6, 8, 10 rounds, 12 rounds, these body shots will hold him in good stead. He'll start wearing fighters down.
Well, I'm liking the little half steps back as well. You know, he's keeping his distancing good. And
I think Jake just trying to force the pace a little bit, trying to come forward, but... he's doing a good job, Nathan, of keeping him on his back foot. When Jake attacks, like you said, little half steps, making him miss, and then straight back on the front foot, stalking him. Looks like a strong fellow as well, Nathan. I think the shot here for Nathan would be an uppercut, a right uppercut.
Yeah, jab, bring him onto the shot, uppercut.
Yeah, walk
half step back.
It. Another good round, no mistake in there, 2-0 there. Henry Wharton, good amateur and a good pro as well. Very, very tough man.
Yeah, one of Leeds' finest, Henry Wharton. Still held in very, very high regard in Leeds, quite rightly.
Yeah. I think he fought a Champs Camp fighter in the amateur days, Eric Noy, I think he fought.
Really, yeah?
Yeah, in the ABAs, I think he might be in like the semi-finals. Very, very good amateur.
This Mary J. Blige?
I wouldn't know, mate, who's Mary J. Blige. Before my time, that, mate.
Before his time, he says. I reckon this is Gary Booth's CD playlist.
By the way he's dressed, I don't think so.
What is he wearing today?
Oh, my goodness.
Okay, round three of four. This is our last bout of the evening. Nathan Shepherd making his pro debut. He's bought a fair few from York. He's in there with Jake Bray, the Stainforth Chuck Norris. Crowd's loving it.
They are getting behind the man.
And he's boxed well so far. Nice and controlled. Controlled aggression.
He's been pretty much punch perfect so far.
So just look there defensively. He's just keeping his distance. He's using his forearm nicely. He's measuring his range well. If Jake starts to attack, he just takes a half step back, resets himself.
Yeah, and Jake's tried to make a fight of it. He has tried to push forward and throw his shots, but he's been very, very smart as Nathan.
Didn't think I'd hear a chance of Yorkshire, but we're hearing them loud and clear. And it's been fought at a good tempo, the fight.
Yeah, it has, yeah. Looks like a fit fighter, well conditioned. And fair play to Jake, he's tried to really make a fight of it and he's trying to come forward, but I think it's just been Nathan's class has just stopped Jake from working.
To me, that the body shots have just kept him on, you know, just kept him at a respectable range because he doesn't want to feel them, doesn't want to get in too close. But I've got to give Jake some credit here as well, because when he finds his moments, he is trying to come back. He is trying to come back with something like there. He's trying to come under and come back, yeah, with the left hook there. And they're a good little right uppercut into the rib cage. But Nathan looks he looks the real deal. He looks decent.
Yeah, he looks very good. Well skilled, well conditioned, good temperament, thinking fighter. And he looks like he's got some power behind his shots as well.
And he's not let the crowd drag him into like a wild, sort of reckless, you know, sort of rhythm.
No, because that's what you've got to be careful of. What you've got to try and do is you've got to try and block the crowd out and fight the fight that you fight in the gym. You can't just come here and let all the hard work that you've been working on go out the window just because there's a few cheers and sing songs and that. But he's done that well for me. He's really done that well. He's been very, very focused in there. He's got a good array of shots. I like how he works the body. I like how he doesn't smother his work. He's at a nice distance.
Well, that's quite the write-up, Dan, from you. Because normally you're a bit miserable, aren't you?
Only when I'm with you, mate.
Three rounds in the bank in our main event of the evening. We're at the Fuse in Partington. Well, M31 Promotions show. Gary Booth putting on a great show today on Sunday afternoon. It's rocking in here. I've got all the tunes going on. I wish the cameraman would pan on some dancing around the ring here, because there's some proper movers here. I mean, you can actually see it on the screen here, left, on the left of our screen.
Look at that.
Wearing the Levi's top. He is going for it.
He stole your moves, Aki. Call the cops.
Go on, lad. This is what it's about. Enjoying, having a good Sunday afternoon out. Enjoying yourself. Few boogies. Few dance moves. He has definitely been washing you and the at Sankey's.
Mate, I've already made the joke. He stole your moves, mate. Aki Karim, number two.
Fourth and final round of a good afternoon's boxing here. Nathan Shepherd, pro debut. He's bought a few from York. He's in there with Jake Bray, the Stainforth Chuck Norris. So far, Dan, we probably have got three in the bank there for Nathan, but good right hand.
Nice right hand, just went round the side of the guard. Yeah, it's been a shutout so far.
But he has had to think, and it's not, you know, Jake's definitely played his part. He's not just come over here and just danced around the ring.
Yeah, it's a shutout, but it's a shutout because of the work that Nathan's been doing. Nathan's fought a very, very good fight here. I think we've given him all the praise in the world in this fight. He's looked really good. Yeah. Array of shots.
And that's it there. Jake is...
And Jake's really tried to make a fight of it.
Exactly. I was just about to say exactly the same words. He's really tried to make a fight of it, and he deserves some credit as well. I think he was Well, we'll ask him afterwards, but I think he might have been winded by a body shot in the first round, actually. And he's coming back in. That's a, you know, he's tried a good little uppercut there.
Yeah. And you know what? I'm glad that Jake's trying to bring the fight to him and put him under pressure, because it's all a development at this stage of your career. And it'd be good if Jake comes and he's throwing the shots like he has been, and he's been giving Nathan stuff to think about. So it'll all hold him in good stead for when he starts progressing through his career.
And his nickname's Shep Dog. And that's because, I asked him earlier and he said it's because he just fights like a dog. But actually, he's fought quite cultured, I'd say. You know, controlled in a good manner. He's held his form well.
Yeah, because it's all right enjoying a fight and enjoying a scrap, but that gets you so far. You've got to have the boxing ability. You've got to be able to follow game plan and have that discipline. And that's what he's shown in here. If he'd have walked in there and he'd have just had a fight with Jake in the middle of the ring, it might have been a different fight, but he's gone about it the right way. He's thought about it, he's jabbed, he's moved, he's made him miss. And that's why it's been a comfortable fight for him, and that's why he looks like he's well on the way to victory, winning all four rounds. And a dream debut, really.
And that was good defensive work there, because Jake did try and sneak under there, roll, and come over with that left hook.
Yeah, Jake looks a little out of ideas there. He just kind of went forward, trying to lead him in. He's trying what he can. He's an experienced operator, but Nathan's just handling it very, very well. I think Nathan will be happy with this. I think Henry Wharton in the corner, I think he'll be happy with it. And he'll just be happy to get the debut out of the way, and then he can start, obviously, progressing him.
Yep. And when the bell does sound, that will conclude a good afternoon boxing here. There were some pullouts on the lead up to the final night, where there were seven fights. We ended up with five, but you know what? It's been a good afternoon of boxing.
Five quality fights, Aki. There was no mismatches. They're all even fights. We've had a couple of upsets. It was good. It was. And to top it up with that was a brilliant fight. That I'm really excited to see where Nathan goes from here.
And of course, we will get the confirmation from the MC Rob Blundell, and then we will be speaking to Nathan afterwards.
A lot of respect there, just to Jake telling Nathan that he hits hard. Obviously Jake's an experienced operator, and that even that praise will mean a lot there to Nathan.
I think his fans are going to go away happy here. They've made the journey, and it's still only 7 o'clock. They've still got the whole evening in front of them.
Ladies and gentlemen, we please have a big round of applause for Blundell. After four rounds, we go to Dan and Sargentson's scorecard, which reads 40 points to 36 in favour of your winner. Now 1-0 as a professional.
I'm here with the winner, Nathan Shepherd, who gets his professional career off to a great start there, going 1-0. And you put a few here to support you, haven't you?
Yeah, I've got a bit got a following. Like, I appreciate them all, like from York, travelling over on a Sunday night. I appreciate every one of them. Yeah, it's good to be back in there after a year out. You know, obviously first four-rounder, about a year out the ring, so just wanted to get in there and feel my way into it. You know, I thought I could have boxed a little bit better, but, you know, it's my debut. I'll come back again, fight again in 4 weeks. So.
Well, Jake's quite an experienced kid. Yeah, you went in there, you did what you needed to do. Yeah. I heard him saying to you afterwards that you hit hard.
Yeah, he said bloody hell, how hard I punch. So that's good to hear. He says he's been distance with a few lads, some good lads. So, yeah, that's what he said to me. He said, you know, I punch really hard, so it's good to know.
Now, you said there you're out again in 4 weeks. Tell us about that.
Yeah, 4 weeks Friday, I boxed in Leeds, so I'll be a lot better for that one now. I've had my ring rust off after a year out, so I'm looking forward to the next fight.
Yeah, for people who don't know as well, you've got a legend in Henry Wharton in your corner. Yeah. You know, one of Leeds' very finest, so that must be great as well, just to learn from someone who's been there, done it as well.
Of course, yeah, he's an unbelievable coach. So my other coaches, Ron, and, you know, Jez, James Coops, all of them. But yeah, it's good to have Henry there, telling me what to do and keeping me in check. So.
It looks like some of your firm are going for a bit of a party now, is that right?
Yeah, they're all mental, all of them. They love it, so I look forward to just being busy this year and getting out again.
Are you going to give yourself a day to celebrate today, or what's it, straight back in the gym?
Maybe have a few days off on Scram, but yeah, no drink. I'll have a few drinks on next fight. Yeah.
All right. Well, listen, it was great to see you. Great for all the BBTV viewers to see you in action. And we're looking forward to seeing you again in 4 weeks' time. Anything you want to do, a final message for us?
Yeah, just thank everyone for tuning in. I'll see you again.
All right. Top man. There we go, guys. Now, I think he's coming this way. Yeah? This way, mate. Yeah. So, we hope you've enjoyed a good night of boxing here. We're just getting the team going through here. Hope you've enjoyed a good night of boxing. Five pro fights, Sunday afternoon. It's a shame the football is going on at the same time, but, you know, it is what it is. Don't forget, guys, in 40 minutes, we have got a very special interview on our channel. It's a bio with a respected guy in the boxing trade, Kerry Kayes. That's going to be live at 8 p.m. You don't want to miss that. Some serious, serious stories, the Hatton days, all sorts of stuff in there. But, yeah, we hope you've enjoyed the show. Thanks for tuning in, and see you at the next one.